click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know what is actually chemical equilibrium, and related to that we are going to discuss about a chemical equilibrium but of the two different phases. So what are those? Let us talk about it. So the two of the chemical equilibrium reactions are basically characterized into two things, that is homogeneous and heterogeneous equilibrium. So what is actually homogeneous equilibrium? Let us talk about it. So the equilibrium in which all the reactants and the product exist in a single homogeneous phase is called as a homogeneous equilibrium. So this is very similar to that of the homogeneous and heterogeneous reaction that we have did a lecture earlier. So since we are talking about a homogeneous reaction, or now we are talking about a homogeneous equilibrium, obviously when it comes to homogeneous reaction, we have got to know that the reactants and the product, the both should have the same or a single phase that is state, and that's the reason that they are called to be homogeneous, having the same state or having the same phase. So similarly, it is also applicable to the homogeneous equilibrium when the equilibrium is being attained because of the reaction between the reactant and the product, the rate of the reaction and the rate of the forward reaction for them, if both are the same, and there would be certain point or there will be certain stage where we could find that the mixture would be in equilibrium, but that mixture should be basically in a homogeneous phase, and that is the reason that we are talking about homogeneous equilibrium. For example, suppose if I take an example like this one, like if nitrogen and oxygen, if they are both reacting with each other and so as to form basically an equilibrium, chemical equilibrium state, so therefore we could call it as, so there will be a point where we could get to know that the concentration of the reactant and the concentration of the product or that would be the same thing. But we are concerned with the homogeneous phase, so therefore we know that nitrogen is the one which is in gaseous phase, while that of the oxygen is also present in a gaseous phase, while the nitric oxide is also present in gaseous phase. So therefore the equilibrium that has been attained in this case, so therefore the mixture will be itself a homogeneous mixture or of a single phase, and that's the reason this is an example of a homogeneous equilibrium. So now let us move on to the next one that we have, and that is heterogeneous equilibrium. So what is heterogeneous equilibrium? Let us talk about it. So the equilibrium in which the reactants and the product exist in two or more phases is known as heterogeneous equilibrium. So therefore, obviously when a reaction is undergoing through, or it has a chemical equilibrium because of the reversible reaction, and we'll get a certain stage that is known as a chemical equilibrium, and where we could find that the reactant and the product have the same kind of, having a constant concentration of the reactant and of the product. But it is not necessary that the both of the reactant and the product should be of the same phase. They can be of different phase depending on what is the reactant and what is the product. And that is the reason that we could find two or more than two kind of phases in that equilibrium stage. And that is makes the reaction to be called as a heterogeneous equilibrium. So let me give you an example in this case. For example, when CaCO3 is been converted into basically, and suppose this is a irreversible reaction. So therefore this CaCO3 has been converted into CaO plus, that is CO2. So when we are talking about the forward reaction, then it has been clear that CaCO3 or calcium carbonate will turn into calcium oxide and it will liberate carbon dioxide. But even that calcium oxide and the carbon dioxide, they both will react with each other so as to form CaCO3. So in this case, if I am talking about the phase, or if I am talking about the physical state, then CaCO3, that is calcium carbonate, is present in solid state, while that of the CO2 is being present in a, suppose it is always present in a gaseous state, and while that of the CaO is present in, suppose, solid state. So in this case, you can't find only a single phase, means there would be a kind of equilibrium that we could attain, and that should say have the same kind of phase. But in this kind of reaction, it is not that so. The reason behind that is we could get different phase, that is one is solid, one is gas. So that equilibrium is the one which consists of two or more phases. And that two phases in this case is solid and gas. So that's the reason that it has been called to be, that is heterogeneous equilibrium. So therefore, this were the two difference, and this were very similar to that of what we have did earlier in the terms of heterogeneous reaction and homogeneous reaction. So very simple one that you have understood it, and based on that only we could determine that what would be the chemical equilibrium and what would be the phase of that one. So that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this video very clearly, and I hope you will share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.